Hello students, welcome to EduTab and welcome to the 15th lecture of ARD Static series. Today what we will study about? We will study about fisheries, and in fisheries we will discuss the classification of fish, how we can do it and what are the different classes. Okay, before moving on, remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and if you want the PDF will be uploaded in next 24 hours in our Telegram channel too. And also make sure you join our Telegram channel too. Okay, now moving to the timetable part, you can see today we are discussing what? Classification of fish and other part we have discussed, okay? These all we have discussed in the YouTube session at 1 PM. Today we are discussing the classification of fish. And I know many of you are very nervous about this particular topic. Don't worry, once you have attended the class, you will be sure that you will attempt most of the questions from this particular topic. Okay, moving to the class, first of all, we will discuss the homework question. So as the question was, which of the following animal has maximum protein percentage? Okay. Which of the following animal has maximum protein percentage? Your options were cow, buffalo, sheep, camel, or none of the above. So as I can see, most of you have given the correct answer. So Sajal has given the correct answer, Mamta has given the correct answer, Satyajit, Western Wing, Deepika, Konika, Pratyush, Nikhil, Madhur, Lokesh, and Tarun. All of them have given the correct answer, and of course the correct answer is your sheep. Okay. Hello TJ, so I think most of you are revising the particular question that we discussed. Okay, very good. So now let's move to today's topic, and today we are discussing the fisheries classification. So first of all, let's take a quick look at the PYQ. So we have a rough idea ki kis tarah ke question aate hai, what is the trend, what is the most important topic. So you can see from here, the question was, which of the following fish lives in the fresh water but breed in the salt water? Your option are anadromous, catadromous, oceanodromous, sea dromous, or none of the above. Okay, so what are these fish? What are the fresh water and salt water? What are these migration types that we will all discuss? Okay. Hello to everyone. Okay, welcome to the class. Now let's discuss ki how we can classify the fish. So before knowing about the classification, okay, if anybody want to attempt the question, do attempt it. Okay, we will check ki kis kis ne sahi answer de rakhe hai at the end of the video. So moving to the today's class. So first of all, before classifying the fish, we should know what is a fish. So of course, fish comes in the animal. It's a type of animal, but what kind of animal? How you can classify the fish? See, there are some characteristics, based on them you can classify the fish, and these characteristics are, first of all, for respiration. Okay, these animals use what? Gills. For locomotion, okay, what will these use for locomotion? They don't have limbs, they are using fins. Okay, heart is two-chambered, they basically are covered in the Pisces group. Okay, some are different, but that is exception, but mostly Pisces group covered all the type of fishes. Okay, now moving to the classification of fish. See, we are not talking about the taxonomic classification. Why? Because for NABARD examination, the taxonomy is not important. If you are giving a fishery specific exam, then you can go for the taxonomic, that become very important. But for your NABARD examination, they won't ask you ki bhai Perciformis family which fish belong to. This kind of question won't be there. So we will do the classification of fish keeping the mind your NABARD examination. Okay, so according to NABARD examination, we will see three type of classification based on, first of all, habitat. Where do the fish live? Kahan rehti hai wo? So that will be the habitat. Where second basis will be the feeding habit, what they are eating. So that will be the second basis of classification. Third will be the migration. So those of you who don't know what migration is moving from one place to another place for a specific purpose. That becomes your migration. So if there is any query outside the course, we will discuss at the end of the video. Okay. So I'm so sorry, because we need to maintain the flow of the content that we are discussing. So if you have any query regarding the examination or outside the question or the topic we are discussing, do let me know at the end of the video. There will be 10 to 15 minutes given only to the queries. Okay, so for now let's focus on the classification. So first of all, let's discuss about the habitat. So where do the fish lives? Of course, water. But then only fish can also be classified in what? Freshwater fish, brackish water fish, and marine fish. Now what are these? See, water is there where you can find the fish, but what kind of water is that? what kind of salt percent is there present in the water, we can classify water into three groups, that are again fresh, brackish and salt water. Talking about the fresh water refers to any water that has salinity between 0% to 1.05%. Don't get confused ki yahan pe 1.05% likha hai, to salinity 1.05% hi honi chahiye. No, that is not the case. Maximum it can be up to 1.05. Again, talking about the marine. So marine, that means sea water, you can also write it. Okay, jo pani hame samudra mein mil raha hai, that is called marine fish. And there the salinity is more than 30%. Okay, so that will be marine. So in between these, 1.05, more than 1.05 and less than 30%, we will call it brackish water. And these fish usually found in the estuaries. Okay, estuaries is a kind of water body that is between fresh water and marine water. Jahan aapke samudra ka pani and fresh water rivers ka pani mil raha hai. These kind of body are brackish water bodies. Okay. आपकी सॉल्ट लेक एंड दैट आर ऑल्सो ब्रैकिश वाटर बॉडीज. ओके, सो कीपिंग इन द माइंड दैट सी व्हेन योर फिश इज लिविंग इन द फ्रेश वाटर और व्हेन योर फिश इज लिविंग इन द मरीन वाटर, दीज टू काइंड ऑफ फिश आर स्टीनोहेलाइन. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस स्टीनोहेलाइन मीन? सी, स्टीनो मीन्स नैरो. ओके, हेलाइन मीन्स सॉल्ट. It means the both the fresh water and the marine fishes, they can't, you know, get enough or can tolerate much of the fluctuation in the salinity of the water. What am I saying? Suppose aapki ek fish hai, suppose for example take carp. So these your carp normally found in the fresh water, salinity has 0%. So quickly you put the fish in the suppose 10% salinity, these fish will quickly die. They won't be able to tolerate the temperature. Talking about the marine water fish, see, if you keep these marine water fish, suppose there is tuna, that's a very popular marine fish. So take tuna and put this fish in suppose 15 degree salinity, they will quickly die. So both are stenohaline, they can't take good fluctuation. Okay. See, when we are talking about percentage and ppm, it's a similar kind of thing. Percentage, how we calculate, but in 100 gram we are calculating the grams, that will be percentage. Again, when we are talking, this can also be written as 1.05 ppm. Parts per million, quite good. Okay, mg per liter, you can also see 1.05 mg per liter bhi likha hoga, that will be the similar thing. That's the thing, you can say ki kg likh diya, gram likh diya, but you can convert it, and it for salinity, that the good thing is it will be similar. Okay, now moving to the next part. So when we move, sorry, when we move to the brackish water, these are urehaline. What does this mean? It means they can tolerate a wide fluctuation in salinity. Inko aap rakh dijiye 10 ppm pe or 10% pe, or you can keep them at 25 ppm. They will survive the wide fluctuation. Okay. These freshwater and marine fish, they can't tolerate the wide fluctuation, but these urehaline fishes can tolerate the salinity fluctuation. So that's why they are urehaline. These two are stenohaline. So in future too, whenever you see term ure and you know steno, steno means narrow fluctuation they can tolerate, and ure means they can tolerate wide fluctuation. Okay. Now again, moving to the fresh water bodies aapki kya hoti hai? River hai, lake hai, pond hai, these are all fresh water. These can be cold water fishes and warm water fishes, that we will discuss. Now moving to the marine, marine can also be of three types, that is pelagic, demersal and deep sea fishes. Okay. See, stenohaline mean they can't tolerate a wide range of fluctuation. Jaise ye 1.5 tak hume fish mil rahi hai, agar aap isko rakh do, suppose 3 ppm pe, so they will quickly die. Okay, they won't be able to you know tolerate the fluctuation. ये ज़्यादा salinity नहीं सह सकती है. Similarly for marine, ये हमें मिल रही है salt water में. So अगर आप इनको 30% पे ही हमें मिल रही है, keep them at 20 ppm, they will die. और 20% too. ठीक है, so 30% से आप इनको 20% पे water change कर दो, they will die. So that is steno, कि ज़्यादा fluctuation नहीं सह पा रही है. Ure means they can you know tolerate the wide fluctuation. Okay, is that clear? Do let me know in the comment or I'll re-explain it. Okay, now talking about the freshwater bodies, again I have discussed river, pond, these are all your, even reservoir that we you know dam banate hum jo, that is all your freshwater. Talking about the freshwater fishes, these are Again, you can see river lake, these are found in even water channels, they can found in salinity, we have discussed. They are usually excrete ammonia. Okay, talking about the excretion. So they excrete ammonia and small quantity of urea is there. That's a usual case. Now, freshwater fishes can further be divided into cold water and warm water. And this classification is done based on temperature. So if they prefer to live in the cold water or they can only survive in the cold water, they will be called as stenothermal or the cold water fishes. Again, we see term steno, that means they can only tolerate a... That we will cover, Yashoda, just let me finish it and then I'll discuss it, okay. So talking about the cold water fishes, these are stenothermal fishes. That means they can't, you know, tolerate a wide range. Again, whenever you see the fishes living in the cold water, usually what happens, the condition with them is they need good amount of dissolved oxygen, that is your DO. Okay, jitni bhi fish hamari cold water mein, hills mein aap dekhte honge, Himalaya ke paas milengi, these fish need high amount of oxygen in the water. That's why they are usually found in the flowing water. Pani jitna flow karega, oxygen utni mix hogi atmosphere se. And high oxygen demand is there in the case of the cold water fishes. And again, optimum temperature you can see here. Example are trout and loaches. Cold water fishes, you can see trout and loaches. Again, see, you will have to, you know, for NABARD examination, go for the broad term. If you talk about trout, there are different kind of trout, okay. Brown trout is there, rainbow trout is there. So that you can go for that. Talking about loaches, similarly, tall species is there too. Okay, so there are wide example are there. Because again, in cold water, there's a many species, more than 100 species are there. So you can't go for every species there. What you'll have to do, you'll have to remember a group. Okay, group, similar categories ke naam pe we have formed the group, so go for the name of the group. So here you can see trout is one example, loaches, these are the example. These are the picture of the trout and loach, as you can see. Moving to the next group, that is warm water. See, warm water are again urethermal. It means they can tolerate a wide range of temperature. Also, DO fluctuations, they can tolerate. Even when we talk about catfish, catfish ka itna interesting example hai, they can almost live in 1 ppm. It means 1 ppm DO. Okay, we are talking about DO. So dissolved oxygen itni low hai, 1% dissolved oxygen hai, they can survive in that too. And usually in their case, they need more than 8 ppm. 6 to 8 ppm is usual case. Okay, they can't survive below 6 ppm, usually the cold water fish. But here warm water, usually they need at least 3 ppm of dissolved oxygen. But in some case, they can go for 1 ppm too. So that's why they are urethermal. It means they can tolerate wide range of temperature as well as oxygen. Dissolved oxygen that is found in the water. Now temperature should be between 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. Again, this is the optimum temperature. Okay, not ki 27 se agar 26 ho gaya, they will die. It's not like that. It's the optimum ki best growth hume isme milegi. Okay, so that was about the freshwater fish. If you have any confusion or any doubt, any question, do let me know in the chat section. So we can quickly discuss it. If it is clear, do let me know that in the chat too, okay, so I can move. So for your examination, what you have to remember from there, again, just go for basic example, Rohu. For warm water, Magur, and Rohu is again carp. Magur is your catfish, okay? No, warm water and cold water. Warm water means garam, halka sa garam pani. Sorry, cold water means halka sa thanda pani chahiye inko. Warm water means inko halka sa garam pani chahiye. That's the both fresh water fish. Ye fresh water ki do classification hai. Okay? वॉम वॉटर ध्रुव सी सैलिनिटी इज समथिंग दैट यू हैव टू सी कि काफी बार क्या होता है सी वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कि रिवर ओशन से मिल रही है सो दिस इज आर रिवर दिस इज आर ओशन सो वेन विल यू से कि यहां तक फ्रेश वॉटर है एंड यहां से हमारा ब्रैकिश वॉटर है यहां से हमारा मरीन वॉटर शुरू है सो यू गो फॉर कि ठीक है 1% तक बोल देते हैं कि फ्रेश वॉटर है सो दैट इज द केस बट मोस्टली द सैलिनिटी समटाइम्स गो 0% टू इन द फ्रेश वॉटर केस वेन वी आर टॉकिंग इन द टर्म्स ऑफ द क्लोरिनिटी ओके नो नो सी दिस वन इज दिस क्लासिफिकेशन कोल्ड वॉटर वार्म वॉटर वी ओनली से इन द केस ऑफ फ्रेश वॉटर फिशेज इन कोल्ड वॉटर वी डोंट से ओके ये सॉरी इन केस ऑफ मरीन वॉटर और द मरीन फिशेज वी डोंट से दिस इज द वार्म वॉटर फिश दैट इज फाउंड इन द सी वी डोंट से इट लाइक दैट येस दैट इज ट्रू बट ओनली इन द केस सी इफ योर फिश इज वार्म वॉटर फिश ऑफकोर्स good temperature is required but if you take this trout and try to you know grow that at 32 degrees celsius due to low metabolism or some you know problem in the metabolism they will die trout will die so what you'll have to do but most fish tropical region mein hamare world mein sabse zyada fishes milte hain even if we are talking about ocean or the fresh water and usually they prefer 27 to 32 degrees suppose we are talking about common carp this is a very good example usually in china the common carp you know lives in the cold water and the growth period like for one to grow in the 1 kg they take 3 years 2 to 3 years but in india what happened we introduced common carp in the warm water and in 8 to 12 month they attain the 1 kg weight okay hota kya hai case mein jab hum fresh water mein we are keeping the fish unko they start feeding okay food present hai those they start feeding and they their growth increases also himalayan lake they can found See, when we are talking about Himalayan area, Himalayan lake, it means when you are talking about whole world, they can find in the different areas too. But in the northeast, you can also find the cold water fishes. Okay, in northeast, Brahmaputra, you know, origin. Whenever you know your Himalayas or any other cold water temperature, wherever the temperature is low, your fish can be kept. Also, see what happened. One case is your raceway. Suppose you have prepared a raceway. You have prepared a raceway. When you are living in Delhi and by artificial means you have you know control the temperature aapne temperature maintain karke rakha hai 16 degree suppose there you can in Delhi also keep the cold water fish that is trout you can keep there okay but the condition is naturally when we are talking about they are usually found in the cold climate and cold climate in case of water in India where it exists in the Himalayan state also in the northeast okay So this was the case, and also see when we talk about the Ravi and all rivers now. So they cross the Punjab and Haryana too. So in the upper region too, in Punjab upper region too, you can find these cold water fishes. Okay, it all depend on the temperature. So what happens? Suppose there is Ganga. So up to 20 degree or 24 degree, you will find cold water fish. As the temperature increase. Slowly इनकी पॉपुलेशन डिसअपियर होंगी एंड दीज विल स्टार्ट अपियरिंग ओके सो दैट इज द केस इट्स नॉट कि यहाँ पे लाइन बनी है इससे पहले यू विल फाइंड कोल्ड वॉटर इससे पहले यू विल फॉर्म वार्म वॉटर फिश अ लिटिल फ्लक्चुएशन कभी टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज हुआ दे विल मूव दिस साइड टेम्परेचर डिक्रीज हुआ दे विल गो दिस साइड मोर सो इट्स काइंड ऑफ दैट थैंक यू सो मच ध्रुव बट द केस इज सम पीपल डोंट यू नो हैव हिंदी मीडियम सो आई नीड टू I'll try to you know explain some important phenomena in both English and Hindi and for some I'll prefer English. Okay. Now moving to this marine fish, I think everybody is clear on this. If anybody has any other doubt, do let me know. I'll answer. But let's move to the marine fish for now. So talking about the marine fish, first of all, they live in the salt water and salinity of course 30% or higher. No, Yashodhan, there is, if you are from fisheries background and you are, you know, giving the exam in the fisheries, go for that. But if you are in NABARD examination, just go for example, a little bit, example will be enough. Temperature, they won't ask, just broadly remember the term that as we have told, na, ki 15 degree, 24 degree, that will be enough, NABARD examination, that will be enough. Again, go for the group. No need to go for deep example, but again, your IMC and CMC, that is your Indian major carp and Chinese major carp, three are there, Rohu, Katla, Nayan. And in Chinese major carp, we talk about grass carp, silver carp and common carp. So these three, if you can remember, that will be enough. Then again, agar koi special cheez hai, suppose in the catfish, as I have told you, the 1 ppm salicylate, that will be enough. And catfish, in Indian catfish is your Clarius batrachus. So that will be enough. No need to go for that. Lake, whatever, see, if there is cold water lake, they can live there. If you are talking about Nainital lake, so you will find trout there. But if you are talking about a lake in suppose Odisha, so warm water fishes will be there, usually warm water fish. And we find common carp and rohu and all kind of fishes. But of course, for cold water lakes, there will be cold water fishes. Again, you'll have to see koi bhi water body bol rahe, you'll see temperature. Temperature thanda hai, you will find cold water fish. Temperature garam hai, you will find warm water fish. Okay, depending on the temperature. So that out of the way, let's move to marine fish. Again, marine fish, they excrete urea. That is different about them. We don't classify the marine fish according to temperature. In case of marine fishes, we classify them as pelagic, demersal and deep sea fishes. Okay, talking about the pelagic fishes, they are those who live what? They live near ocean surface. Okay, this is our ocean. Suppose this is the total depth of the ocean. It goes something like that. So suppose the fishes that are found throughout the surface, they will be called your pelagic fishes. Okay. Of course, it will be above 30%. Gem, that will be above 30%. Between 31 to 30%, that will be your brackish water fish. Okay, 30% or higher. Oh, it will be higher, not lower than 30%. That will be higher than 30%, between 1 to 30%, and that is lower than 1%. Okay, I'm so sorry for that. Now, talking about the marine fishes, those who are found in the surface, these are your pelagic fishes. Suppose up to certain length, you find some fishes, that is demersal fishes, but those fish who are found in complete darkness, jahan sun ki rays pahunch hi nahi rahi hai, these are your deep water. Okay, so that is your pelagic fish, deep water fish, and sorry, pelagic, demersal or deep water fish. Okay, so pelagic, they live at the surface. Your example are mackerel and sardine, very important fish in the India. They form most of the fishes, so maximum catch inhi ka milta, and they are reverse. If mackerel is more, sardine catch will be less. If sardine is more, mackerel catch will be less. Okay, proportional relation they have. Talking about the demersal fish live on the feed near the ocean, near the bottom. But the case here is, they are not completely living in the aphotic zone. Aphotic zone means pelagic fish, they live in the photic zone, jahan sun ki rays aa rahi hai. They live in diffused zone, jahan sun ki rays aa rahi hai, but they are not clear. So they live in diffused zone. Okay, demersal fish, they live and feed at the bottom of the lake. Talking about the deep sea fish, these live in the darkness or aphotic zone of the ocean. As you can see, these are there. These are lanternfish and swordfish. And one good thing to know about deep fish, they are usually bioluminescent. It means they have some kind of organ that produce light. Light producing organ in ke paas naturally present hota hai. Okay, these produce light. They have strip that produce light. So these are your demersal, pelagic and deep water fish. If anybody has any doubt, do let me know in the comment. And if everything is clear, do let me know that in the comment too. Okay, another thing that people get confused in, the concept of capture and culture. So see, what happens whenever you are using the net, gear, okay, you are using boat. So you are using different kind of craft and gears to capture or catch a fish. You can do that both. Aap ocean mein bhi ja sakte hain net use karne ke liye, aap river mein bhi ja sakte hain net use karne ke liye. In that case, you will call it capture fishes. But when you are taking the sea route, okay, you are taking taking the fish babies, little fish you are growing, then you are feeding them and then they are growing to be whole fish. In that case, you will call it culture. Again, this culture can also be done in, in case of freshwater fish. अगर जब हम फ्रेश वाटर में कल्चर कर रहे हैं, वी विल कॉल इट एक्वा कल्चर. ओके, एंड व्हेन वी आर डूइंग द कल्चर ऑफ द फिश इन द मरीन वाटर, वी विल कॉल इट मैरी कल्चर. सो So that's a concept. It is different than the thing we are discussing about the classification, but it is related and the terminology is important. That's why I have told you. Okay, now moving to the next classification, that is on the basis of feeding habit. What are fishes eating? So rehti kya we have discussed, now we'll discuss khati kya. So they can be plankton feeder, herbivorous, omnivores and carnivores. So these three we have studied many times. Herbivores means plant material they are eating. Carnivores means they are eating, other animals. Okay, animal origin they are eating. And omnivore means they can eat both. Now, Vikram Kumar, deep sea, please clarify your question. For now, I'll discuss this. Now, the thing important is a plankton feeder. What are plankton feeder? See, you have to understand the term plankton. What are plankton? They are minute organisms. Small, you can't see them. Okay, these are very small organisms. Sometimes they are visible. I'm not saying they are microscopic, but they are very small and they have no floating power. Okay, they are free floating. They have no locomotory organ that they can use to move. And what they do, they can either do photosynthesis, and they will be called phytoplankton. Okay, and some plankton, what they do, they eat this photoplanktons. In that case, they will be called zooplanktons. Okay, so what are your plankton? These are basically aquatic minute organism, either of both animal and plant origin, that act as the food. So you must have also heard ki maximum oxygen is produced by the oceanic algae. That oceanic algae is also plankton. Okay, now this plankton feeder, example of plankton feeder is your silver carp and katla. Talking about silver carp, they basically eat phytoplankton. That means they eat minute organism, and these minute organism do photosynthesis. Talking about katla, they are zooplankton eater. That means they eat plankton, but those plankton are also dependent on phytoplankton. Okay, and again, this silver carp is your Chinese major carp. This katla eater is our Indian major carp. It means origin is Indian. Talking about the grass carp, these are herbivorous fish. It means they plant material, whatever is grown, na, aquatic weed are there. So water hyacinth is there. So azolla is there. They can eat it all. So that is herbivorous fish. Again, example are grass carp and milkfish. This grass carp is your Chinese major carp. Okay, moving to the omnivore fish, example, they can eat everything. They can go for, plant material too. They can eat the other organism, other animal or the other smaller fishes too. These are your omnivore. You can go for common carp and the pearl spot fish. Common carp is again your Chinese major carp. Talking about the carnivorous fish, these are your snake head, also called channa. So if you see channa marulia, channa punctatus, channa naam aega, so that is your snake head. They seem like they are snake, but they are not, they are fishes, okay? And they have very good demand and good price too. Talking about the other carnivorous fish, that is sea bass. Again, don't ask the question ki in mein se kaun si hamari fresh water hai and kaun si marine water hai. They can be fresh water and marine water. Kyun? Ocean mein planktons are present. Ocean mein bhi plankton hote hain, of course, plankton feeder wahan bhi honge. Ocean mein bhi grasses and algae hote hain, toh wahan pe bhi honge. Omnivores in the ocean found to carnivore, ocean found to sea bass, also an example of that. Okay. Dhruv, once we done the discussion, I have added the question, so I told you kaise question aayenge, but common question can be asked, direct question, which of the following fish will be the herbivores, so example will be there. Okay, omnivores ke liye, they will give 5 examples, you have to pick one. So these kind of question can be easily formed there. Okay, so moving to the next part, we will talk about the migration, and this part is very important for your NABARD examination. Repeatedly the question has been appeared from this particular migration topic. Okay, now let's discuss about the migration. What does migration means again? The fish is moving from one place to another place. Why? For feeding, for breeding, for any purpose it can be. Okay, talking about the migration, your migration can basically be of four types. That is potamodromous, anadromous, catadromous and amphidromous. When we talk about potamodromous, it's a kind of migration that fish do from freshwater to freshwater. Dhruv, I'll suggest you go for CMC and IMC. That is again Chinese major carp. I have told you three Indian major carp. That are other three. Then in the case of catfish, go for Indian catfish, channel catfish. थोड़ा सा ग्रुप में बस चार पांच नाम याद कर लो. Okay. Then snake heads are there. Just broad term है. जैसे snake head के लिए चन्ना, you'll have to remember the term चन्ना. Okay. You'll have to remember the term channa. Don't go for ki channa maruleus is there, channa punctatus is there. That will be too much. Just remember the basic name ki, okay, clarius is some kind of fish. And even if you can't remember the, you know, example, just remember the group. Ki catfish hai, they are mostly omnivores. Snake head hai, they are basically carnivores. So this kind of thing you'll have to do. No need to remember ki कार्निवोर्स में कौन सी स्नेक है, की कौन सी वैरायटी है. दैट विल बी टू मच फॉर योर नाबार्ड एग्जामिनेशन. जस्ट गो कि ब्रॉडली क्या क्या होता है, दैट यू विल फाइंड इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड अगेन जस्ट वेट फॉर अ वाइल. वंस वी हैव डिस्कस द पी वैल्यू, यू विल हैव अ रफ आइडिया. दैट्स व्हाई वी ऑलवेज ब्रिंग क्वेश्चन विद द डिस्कशन, सो दैट यू कैन नो कि कैसे क्वेश्चन फ्रेम हो सकते हैं, व्हाट विल बी द लैंग्वेज, व्हाट विल बी द इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. ओके, नाउ मूविंग टू द माइग्रेशन पार्ट. सो फॉर माइग्रेशन यू कैन सी अगेन पोटामोड्रामस. इट मीन्स फिश इज डूइंग migration from fresh water to fresh water. Okay, so what does fresh water to fresh water mean? Remember we have read about the cold water and the warm water fish. So these, what they do, they sometimes move from fresh warm water to cold water for the purpose of breeding. What they need, see, usually when we are talking about the warm water fish और वॉर्म वाटर, वहां क्या होता है, कॉम्पिटिशन बहुत है. कैट फिशेज आर देयर, तो वहां प्रिडेशन बहुत है, प्रिडेटरी फिश बहुत है. सो For breeding, they need a safe ground. So they move जहां पे temperature थोड़ा सा ठंडा होता है. And after breeding, they will come back to feed again in their natural ground. So that is Potamodromus, done from fresh water to fresh water. Talking about anadromous, that are those move from sea water to fresh water. Again, for what purpose? For breeding. Very good example is Hilsa. I think everybody might have heard the name of Hilsa. Okay, so these do anadromous migration, that is from seawater to fresh water. Talking about the catadromous, they are doing just opposite. They are moving from fresh water to seawater. Good example is angula eel. Okay, see, again in the case of angula eel, if you can't remember the angula, just remember the eel, that will be important. Okay, that will be enough. Now moving to amphidromous. Amphidromous is those who move from fresh water to seawater, then move from seawater to fresh water. See why this classification is different. In these two cases, what happens? Usually after breeding, fish dies. But in case of amphidromous, they kept living, so that's why they for 1 year they will come freshwater, then they will move to seawater, then again they will come to the freshwater again. Good example is goby, that big mouth sleeper, and mountain mullet. Okay, so these were your migration based classification of the fish. Quite easy. What you'll have to remember here, first of all, you have to know what does the terms mean. Simple question has been asked in the NABARD ki anadromous batao matlab kya hai. They will ask you ki fish is moving from seawater to freshwater, what you will call it. Fish is moving freshwater to seawater, what you will call it. So these kind of simple terms, simple question will be there. They won't even ask for the examples. Sometime Dhruv, in case, you know, if they are moving in amphidromous fishes we are talking about, they have a special organ. They have salt secreting organs. So what they do, when they are in fresh water, their body start producing salt. Okay. Of course, Ankit, for now, NABARD, every year they have conducted the exam. So, the expectation is, of course, there will be an exam in 2023, of course. Okay, so, I think amphidromous, what happened, they have salt producing organism. So, when they are in fresh water, their salt producing organism get activated and they are maintaining the osmoregulation of the body. Okay, so now that is all. Now, to remove your confusion. Yes, Ankit, the exam will be conducted. I think you just wait for 5 or 10 seconds because see what happened. Your comments are a little late. They are visible to me a little late. So once I have seen it, I'll answer it. But again, they will be, conducted to you or given to you after 5 to 10 seconds. So just wait for a while, a little. Okay. So these are your example of migrated fish. Again, you people are having very, very much confusion what kind of question will be there. So let's move to the PYQs so that you can understand ki kaise question are there from this particular topic. So first of all, the PYQ that we have discussed, that was from the migration, and that question was, which of the following fish lives in fresh water but breed in salt water? Your examples, your options were Anadromous, Catadromous, Oceanodromous, Ceridromous, or none of the above. Harsh, आपके कॉलम बॉटम फीडर्स, सी व्हाट हैपन, आपके ये वाटर बॉडीज है, इसको हम समझ लेते हैं कि तीन टर्म्स में, जो फिशेस ऊपर से स्पेशली सी प्लैंकटन वी हैव रीड ना, सो प्लैंकटन आर फाउंड इन द सर्फेस, सो यूजुअली व्हाट हैपन, दोज हु आर ईटिंग द फूड फ्रॉम द सर्फेस, दीज आर बिकम सर्फेस फीडर, ओके, एंड दोज हु फाउंड द यू नो फूड इन द बॉटम ऑफ द ओशन, सॉरी बॉटम ऑफ द लेक, यूजुअली इट हैपन इन द फ्रेश वॉटर, especially in the case of ponds when you are talking about aquaculture. Isme se agar kisi ko koi terminology nahi pata hai, do let me know if you are having any confusion regarding these terminology, okay? So those who are feeding in the bottom, usually what they are omnivorous, as we have discussed in the case of common carp, okay? So that we called what, bottom feeder. And those fish who move, who can, you know, eat food from anywhere, they can move between the surfaces, these are column feeder. So, example your Rohu. Quite good example. Okay, grass carp can also, see, because what happened, your grass, as a basin area and all, these grass grow like this. So, jo aapki grass carp hogi, they can eat from here too, they can eat from here too, they can eat from here too. So, they become column feeders. Okay, so most of you have given the answer now. So people are confused. So here what we are talking about, to clarify, you will have to know that we are talking the fish lives in fresh water and for a specific purpose they are moving to the marine water or sea water or salt water. So these kind of fish will be known as catadromous fish. Okay, so those of you who have given the answer B are very correct. Those of you who have not given the correct answer, please do understand, we are talking ki rehti pure time wo fresh water mein hai, jab breeding hone ka time aaya, they will move to the sea water, there they will lay egg, and once the eggs and hatch, chote chote fishes ho gaye, they will move, and adult stage they will complete here, okay, juvenile stage mein ye log move karenge, at certain age they will reach there, suppose in 1 month they reach there, from 1 month to up to 2 year, or till they reach maturity, they will live in the sea water only, then they will move to the sea water, as we have discussed. So correct example will be catadromous. Don't get confused, okay? If you are confused, go back, check the video again. So moving to the next question now, this question was in year 2020 phase 1, the question was, which of the following is a cold water fish? Your example is catfish, tuna, herring, cod, or brown trout. Thank you so much, Dhruv. See, this question is quite easy, and those of you who know, very good, and those of you who don't know, good example is, see, your tuna is salt water fish, your herring is again salt water, your cod is again salt water, or salt water mein to cold fish ka, cold water ka koi concept hi nahi hai, so that is out of the way. Now your option are catfish and brown trout. See, catfish can tolerate good amount of oxygen and temperature, but they don't go to the cold water, and one advantage you have is, for cold water fish, there are very less examples. Okay, trout you will read, taw you will read, and some loaches you will read, and some, minor carp you will read. These are the basics, and otherwise there are not much example. Okay, so these are the example, and your correct answer will be, of course, brown trout. Very good. So most of you have given the correct answer. Tarun, Dhruv, Vishali, Kunal, Rathod, okay, everybody has given the correct answer, and that is brown trout. If anybody is still confused, go back and rewind the video, okay, check it again. Now moving to the next question, that question come in 2021 phase 1, so last year it was, which of the following following is a freshwater to freshwater migration? See, quite direct question, quite easy question it is. Since you have studied it, you will be able to give the answer. Your option are Anadromous, Catadromous, Amphidromous, Potamodromous, or Waterdromous. Okay, Konika and TJ has also given the correct answer for the last question. Now the question is this one. Okay, I'll wait for a few seconds. So freshwater to freshwater means, see, we have studied about the warm water, we have studied about the cold water. सो दे विल डू माइग्रेशन बिटवीन देम. अगेन वी कांट सी कि वो वार्म वाटर से कोल्ड वाटर करती है, कोल्ड वाटर से वार्म वाटर करती है, बिकॉज व्हाई, सी देयर फॉर अ स्पेसिफिक पर्पज दे आर कमिंग देयर एंड दे आर अगेन मूविंग इट टू देयर. सो यू कैन से बोथ दे, यू कैन से कि वार्म वाटर से कोल्ड वाटर जा रही है, कोल्ड वाटर से वार्म वाटर जा रही है. बट यूजुअली व्हाट वी डू, वी से दे आर शोइंग अपवर्ड माइग्रेशन. बट इफ समवेयर यू सी डाउनवर्ड माइग्रेशन, बिकॉज वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट माइग्रेशन द फिश इटसेल्फ इज अलाइव. ओके, सो दे आर डूइंग द राउंड अबाउट, वो यहां से यहां जा रही है, यहां से यहां जा रही है. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी से कि बोथ कैन बी अपवर्ड टू डाउनवर्ड, डाउनवर्ड टू अपवर्ड माइग्रेशन कैन बी देयर. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर. ओके, वैशाली, श्री कृष्ण, शशांक, राघवी, ध्रुव, अगेन राठौर, कुणाल एंड तरुण, ऑल हैव गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर. दैट विल बी पोटामोड्रोमस. ओके, सी यू विल बी इजिली एबल टू गिव द आंसर, क्वाइट इजी क्वेश्चन दैट इज. सो डोंट गेट नर्वस इफ यू सी अ टॉपिक. ओके, moving to the next question, which of the following is Potamodramus fish, 2021 phase 1 question that was. See, these are your examples. Again going by the example, talking about herring, that's a seawater fish. Talking about cod, that's a seawater fish. Okay, and those of you who are nervous ki hame kaise pata chalega kaun si sea water hai, kaun si fresh water hai, just study about cold water fish and then take a quick look at the warm water fish. Inke alawa jo hogi wo sabki sab marine water fish hongi, and marine water fish hai, marine water, you know, ocean mein kya hai, large diversity is there, most fishes wahi pe aati hai. So now I won't be actually, you know, targeting the question. And if you're going to read about the salt water or the marine water fish, even in that case go for the group. Like you can read about tuna, and I think I have told you about the cods, that is mackerel too, sardines too. You can go for cod too, that will be sea based, we have discussed. So that will be enough for your examination. And moving to the question now. So okay, Shashank has given the answer, Raghvi has given the answer, Vishali has given the answer, Rathod has given the answer, and of course all of you are correct. The Potamodramus kind of migration is shown in the case of trout. Okay, now moving to the next question, and this will be your homework question. The question is, which of the following is your plankton feeder fish? Your example, your question options are sea bass, common carp, snakehead, silver carp, or both A and D, that is sea bass and silver carp. Okay, do let me know the answer in the comment section. I'll tell the answer in the next video. So thank you so much. Now if you have any query not regarding the things we have discussed, if the general query you have, you can ask me. Okay, so I think there was one query at the beginning of the video, let's check it. Of course Harsh, the marathon will be there. Not 500 questions will be too much for you to bear too, but we will bring the series. I think that will be on 26th. So everybody do join the series. Okay, for the static part of the ARD section, the series will be conducted on 26th. Do join us. Okay, both ma'am, Diksha ma'am, and I will take the classes, and there will be question prepared for that. So moving to the query that was in the beginning. So a person again have asked ki, Dhruv has asked, the content will be enough for examination. See Dhruv, what we are doing while preparing for the topic for your particular 1 PM classes, we are going through the PYQs. Ki kisi particular topic mein se how many questions are there, most question kaun se part mein se aaye hain, that we were discussing. So I will say we are trying to cover your 70-80% syllabus, but again your 20% syllabus is remaining. And NABARD, see NABARD has a tendency, they are sometimes what they do. Okay, now but what they do, they are sometimes change the trend. So for now we are studying according the trend that have been followed since 2017-2018. Okay, we are studying the examination or the paper and what kind of question will be there. See, even in the last example, like ARD we have talked about, na, agriculture engineering, the question PYQs were not much, but since the NABARD examination has, NABARD has changed the trend, that's why we included the topic. So we are trying to cover the most, but still I would recommend go for the other sources too. Try to cover the 20% or even 25% from the other sources too. Okay, so that was for that. If anybody has any other query, do let me know please, otherwise we will end the session. Okay, homework question you will have to attempt in the comment section. And if you don't know the answer, go back, revise the video. What you can do? If you are covering all the BSc AG note, I think that will be enough. बट अगेन कुणाल डोंट गेट यू नो डाइवर्टेड एंड कंफ्यूज. काफी चीज वेन वी आर यू नो कंसिडरिंग द एग्रीकल्चर नोट्स, नाबार्ड्स एग्जामिनेशन इज नॉट टू टेस्ट यूर एग्रीकल्चर, देयर पर्पज इज टू टेस्ट यूर एग्रीकल्चर रिलेटेड टू द रूरल डेवलपमेंट. दैट्स वाई इट इज नॉट ए, इट इज ए आर डी. ओके, डू कीप इन माइंड वेन एवर यू आर स्टडिंग. Raghavi, I think summary sheet will be enough for your examination. If you doubt persist, do call us. You know, no need to hesitate. We will answer your query. Write to us, call us. You can do anything if your query is not enough. But again, if you are going for the summary sheet, that will be enough. See, Jeremy, what I'm again, when you are going for the live course, what happening in live course? We broadly, you know, attend all the cover all the topic. But when we are discussing the YouTube session, what we do? We see NABARD examination, particularly most in a topic. We see ki sabse important part kaun sa hai, that we try to cover. So I would recommend you live course do, and once you are trying to revise everything, since in live course everything has been ended, ARD section has been ended. So go for the live course. Then when it comes come to the time of revision, come to the YouTube classes. Okay. But again, everything will be covered. Either if something is missed there, it will be covered here. If something is missed here, it will be covered there in the LPS courses. Okay, so everything, I think everybody has cleared the doubt. If anybody had doubt, do let me know. Okay, it's 1:45. We'll wait for, you know, 3-4 minutes more. If no query come, we will end the session. So for now, I think that was that for the fisheries topic, and there are few lecture remaining and the exam is near. So make sure you are revising well, okay, practice well. Again, just taking an online class will not be enough. You'll have to revise and revise again, and before the examination too. So that end our class. Thank you so much. If you have any query, please don't hesitate. Do write us. This is our address. You can write to us at hello@edutab.co.in, and you can also visit our website. You can also contact us. Okay, if your query is not solved, okay, good afternoon, Satish. If your query is not solved, do let us know in the comment. In the comment section, we will also try to, answer you. Okay, and sometime what will happen if there is no live class and the class is being, recorded class is being given to you, what you'll have to do if you don't understand something, do let me know. Okay, aquarium business, not very bad idea. I'll try to do it. Okay, thank you, Michael. So what you'll have to do, just revise the syllabus and don't hesitate. Do let us know your query. If you like the class, do let me know that in the comment section too. Okay, thank you so much and have a nice day.